Acharya ji pranam. Ramana Maharishi says, as propounded by all and realized by all true seekers, fixity in the supreme spirit, Brahmanistha, alone can make us know and realize it. It being of us and in us, any amount of discrimination, vivechana, can lead us only one step forward by making us renouncers, by goading us to discard the seeming as transitory and to hold fast to the eternal truth and presence alone. Acharya ji, what is meant by fixity in the Supreme Self? Is it being aware of oneself all the time? Being aware of the sense of I all the time? What is it? Brahm is not an object of thought. Therefore, devotion to Brahm, or devotion to the Supreme, or devotion to the Truth, really do not make any sense literally. What are you devoted to? What are you devoted to? Normally, when you say you are devoted to something, there has to be something to be devoted to. Brahm is nothing in the usual sense of thing. What are you devoted to? Therefore, devotion to Brahm, Brahmanistha or Satyanistha, are words in a different dimension, carrying a meaning in a totally different way. Not in the same way in which you say that you are devoted to your religion or to your country or to your wife. It's a very different kind of devotion. It's a very different plane of devotion. Brahmanistha is just a method to keep checking all your miscellaneous devotions, miscellaneous nishtas. Aren't we devoted to 10,000 things? Are we or are we not? Even though those 10,000 things might be transitory, frivolous, nevertheless, at any given moment, there is so much that we are devoted to. When the great masters say that you must have Brahmanistha, what they are saying is, your nishtha must be only towards Brahm. And about Brahm, they tell us a few things, mostly in the negative. Brahm is not this, Brahm is not this, Brahm is not this, Brahm is not this, right? So about Brahm, they have told us a few things, and they have mandated your nishtha must be directed only towards Brahm. But here we are, and our nishtha is dedicated towards A, B, C, D, E, so much. So what do we have to do? We now have to test our sundry devotions on the touchstone of Brahmanistha. So I am devoted to this, right? I am devoted to my towel. There is nothing so funny about it. There are people who are greatly devoted to stuff that equals the importance of a hand towel in many ways. So here am I, devoted to my towel. The master is asking us to question whether the towel is Brahm, because I ought to be devoted to Brahm, but I am devoted to towel. And which is all right if the towel is Brahm. But is the towel Brahm? Let me now examine the towel for the attributes that go with Brahm. Brahm is attributeless, but the attributelessness of Brahm has been elucidated through many pseudo-attributes. What are those pseudo-attributes? Brahm has no shape, but this has Brahm never came into being, but this came into being. Brahma will never disappear, but it will disappear. Brahma cannot be dislocated, but it can be dislocated. Brahma needs no support, but this needs support. Brahma has no color, but this has color. Oh, everything about this negates the very spirit of Brahma. But I am devoted to this. Conclusion. This devotion is misplaced. This devotion is misplaced and therefore very harmful. I need not be devoted to this. So Brahmanishtha is not really a concept or an object. Brahmanishtha is a tool given to us. Brahmanishtha is a gold standard given to us so that we can assess our miscellaneous devotions and see whether the stuff we are devoted to deserves our devotion at all. When you use Brahmanishtha as the gold standard, then it is obvious that you discover that all that which you had thought of as very important in your life actually holds very little importance. It deserves no devotion at all. What is it that deserves devotion? The masters say, either Nirakar Brahma or that Sakar form of Brahma that will lead you to Brahma. Except these two, who in reality are just one, nothing deserves importance or attention or devotion. Either be devoted to the formless truth itself or be devoted to that form which will lead you to the formless truth. Except for these two, nobody is of any value. That is what is meant by Brahmanishtha. Getting it?